An Academy. Let's crack it.
Sir, sir, मुझे An Academy Comeback की scholarship मिल गई.
अरे वाह यार, congratulations.
Sir, last time खेल रहे थे तो 6th rank थी. अब top 3 में आकर scholarship जीत ली sir.
उड़ दिया सर हैं?
सर थैंक्स टू यू एंड An Academy. आपने गाइड किया था. An Academy के लेक्चर और आपकी क्लासेस की वजह से फूटा है सर.
ये गेमिफाइड रिवीजन क्विज है. प्रिपरेशन बिल्कुल सही हो गया होगा. हां
यस सर, अब बस रिवीजन और आंसर राइटिंग प्रैक्टिस करता रहता हूं.
वेरी गुड वेरी गुड. लेकिन प्रिपरेशन को बूस्ट करते रहना ठीक है. ये कॉम्बैट में पार्टिसिपेट करते रहो और अंकुर बाबू डोंट टेक चांसेस.
Good evening everybody, my name is Vishwadeep and I welcome you all on An Academy Computer Science channel for unlimited learning. This is the session in which we are going to talk about threads and multi-threading. So why we needed threads and multi-threading system, we will talk about that first and then we will see how the threads differ from process. And then we will see few more small concepts regarding the threading and multi-threading. So without any delay, let's get started. Before we start, let me introduce myself. This is my profile. As everybody can see, computer science ranks, masters, experience, the courses and everything is written over here. I always tell you one thing, which is I always following, and that is unlimited learning. I am trying to give you unlimited learning through this channel plus An Academy platform also. So what exactly you can learn is unlimited. It's just that how you want to utilize that content. So content is present on this channel, content is present on An Academy's platform also. Once visit over there, go to anacademy.com or download An Academy Learner app and just follow my profile so that you can access my special classes. Special just because it's absolutely free, no payment you will have to do. So what you can access on An Academy's platform? Free classes. You can access the free classes, means special classes. You can access the practice questions, quizzes, test series. You can access the combat also, which is like scholarship test. So use the code VDEEP10 to unlock every single free content on An Academy's platform. If your aim is to get really higher rank, then you will have to put immense amount of efforts. Whatever the efforts you are putting in, your rank should be directly proportional to it. But sometimes when you put the efforts, your rank will not be as equivalent, high value. Why? Just because you are wasting lot of time in figuring out your doubts, figuring out what is best and what is not, from where what to study and what not, and then lots of other factors are there involved in your particular preparation. If you want to have the chances high that whatever the efforts you are putting in, the same efforts will be directly converted into gate rank, then join An Academy Plus. Plus will provide you live classes which are interactive, hence your learning will be better. You can remember the topics for the longer time, doubt solving. You'll be getting weekly tests. You'll be getting daily practice problems, Hindi English batches and guidance of educators, which makes your time and efforts perfectly utilized. If you want to join An Academy Plus subscription, then this particular subscription you can take for 1 month, 3 months, 6 months, 12 months, 18 months and 24 months. And whatever the target of your exam is, based on that, you can choose any of these subscriptions. I will recommend that you should go for higher level or higher time, longer time duration subscription, just because in which you will have to pay less per month or per day. Use this code VDEEP10 so that you can get 10% discount plus my personal guidance plus my team's support. These are the prices written here after the discount only. Remember, okay? We have one more type of subscription for you, that is Iconic. This Iconic subscription has all the benefits of Unacademy Plus and having a benefit of personal coach. Means you, if you want more personalized and customized preparation, go for Iconic one, in which the person, an expert, will be given to you as one-on-one guidance. The person will give you preparation strategy, will give you study planner customized to your day-to-day activity. The person will track your performance, will give you personalized doubt solving. You will get special notes also, plus practice sets also. You will get study booster session plus personalized test analysis also in this Iconic subscription. This Iconic subscription is available for 12 months and 24 months only, and if you use this code VDEEP10, again you will be getting 10% discount plus my personal guidance plus my team's support for your subscription. Today till tonight we have an offer. Offer is, if you take subscription for 12 months, then 2 months extra will be added in your subscription, and if you use the use and go for 24 months subscription, then you can get 3 months extra for your subscription. Today till tonight only the offer is, use this code VDEEP10 so that you can avail this offer plus 10% discount apart from that. There is a batch also starting today, so if you want to join the Unacademy Plus, join as soon as possible so that you can join the batch which is newly starting and you can follow the structured schedule over the batch. चलिए स्टार्ट करेंगे सेशन को. बट बिफोर वी स्टार्ट द सेशन, व्हाट आई वांट इज, इफ यू आर रेडी फॉर लर्निंग यू शुड टेल मी सर वी आर रेडी फॉर लर्निंग सो दैट आई कैन स्टार्ट द सेशन. ओके, सो टेल मी, आर यू रेडी माय डियर फ्रेंड्स, माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आर यू रेडी? आई वांट एवरीबॉडी प्रेजेंट हियर टाइपिंग द मैसेज, यस यू आर रेडी. व्हाई? जस्ट बिकॉज अंटिल यू पुट द एफर्ट्स of learning, you cannot learn, and for that you need to have more and more and more and more and more concentration. So if you are here present, ready, okay, great, a good response I'm getting, that's great. Let's begin the session. What is the thread? You might have seen these type of definition. Thread is a component of a process or a lightweight process. Provide a way to improve application performance through parallelism. These things are theoretical. You should understand first of all why this particular thread was needed. Okay, now I am going to give you a real life example. Yes, one day one businessman thought that let me build a hostel for the students who are coming to the city for college or coaching or whatever purpose. So he decided that whenever I'll be having new student, I will build some particular room or some particular house for that fellow. So what he decided, the business person decided to go for hostel. Now listen, what he thought, I will give full-fledged facility. So whenever a student was coming, that fellow was building a new house for that and giving it for the rent. So that fellow, what that particular fellow was doing? The fellow was building a house or a particular flat for that student. A particular flat for that student. In that flat, the student had a particular living room, a particular kitchen and bedroom. Then another student came. Second student number came. Thus for second student also, that business person has built the same kind of flat in which living room was there, then bedroom was there and kitchen was there. Then for number 3 also, number 4 also, number 5 also, number 6 also, the businessman understood that every student coming for college or maybe coming for coaching or something, they are spending their maximum time in bedroom for study and all. they are just maximum time they are spending time in bedroom only studying or sleeping, that's it. The kitchen they are using very less time. Living room also very less time. But it's my wastage. Ye to mera waste ho gaya. Why? Just because that fellow has given a lot of space, kitchen, and it's so many accessories in the kitchen, a full-fledged kitchen that fellow is giving and providing to the student, but students are not utilizing it. Students are not utilizing it. But it's a waste time, right? Why? Just because that fellow is giving living room to each and every student separate, giving kitchen to each and every student separate, bedroom each and every student separate, and such kind of 100 students are coming, he is building 100 flats in that particular area. It's a wastage of space. It is a wastage of space, wastage of money, and the return of the money is also not. गलती से मिस्टेक हो गया, द फेलो विल थिंक लाइक दैट. सो वॉट अदर बिजनेस पर्सन, द कॉम्पिटिटर थॉट दैट कॉम्पिटिटर हैज स्टार्टेड अनदर बिजनेस ऑफ सेम टाइप. नाउ कॉम्पिटिटर इज डूइंग वॉट, द कॉम्पिटिटर इज सेइंग दैट वेन एवर अ स्टूडेंट कम्स, दैट फेलो हैज बिल्ट वन कॉमन लिविंग रूम एंड अ कॉमन किचन. आफ्टर दैट फॉर ईच स्टूडेंट दैट फेलो वॉज बिल्डिंग अ बेडरूम ओनली. That fellow was building the bedrooms for each and every student. What happened in that case? Kya ho gaya? Kitchen got shared between multiple bedrooms. Living room shared between multiple bedrooms. In that particular case, second businessman is earning more money, saved a lot of space, lot of money also, and return of the money is also good. You know why? Just because every time a new student comes, I will not have to replicate entire flat. I had to replicate only one thing which is required separate for each and every student, a bedroom for sleeping and studying. Understood? Here in this particular case, what happened? The second businessman was earning better. And this is what the basic concept of thread. Basic concept of thread. Now, let me just put this example into your real operating system example. If suppose there is a process, student is a process, let's say. Okay, so there is a process. That particular process is doing some work. Suppose my requirement is like this, that I will have to perform the same operation, same particular process execution I want, but I need two instances of that. Two instances. Why two instances? Just because for two different data, I need to perform the same operation. It's like a web request. When you send a web request, there is a process, listener process at the end of Google's server. That particular process is listening your request, whatever the request you have sent. But that's not the only request now. There are multiple requests. So that listener process will be replicated for as many as requests are coming. But the problem here is, if you are replicating the processes, it will be a very tedious task. Same operation, same code, only few things are changed in two process instances, but you are replicating entire process, right? And to eliminate this problem is, aapne agar replicate kiya process ko, process is replicated, hence you are going to have lot of space in the memory for each and every process. Yes, heavy processes are there. Yes, no sharing is there. Yes, in that particular case, resources will be required more, memory will be required more. And here comes the example of threads. So what exactly the motivation of multi-threading? This, that when we need multiple instances of process, then we will not create the copy of entire process. We will just copy the process, but in such a way that we will keep shareable things common. like kitchen in this example, sharing shareable things common for all the small instances, and whatever is required separate we will keep separate. जो चीज सेपरेट चाहिए वो सेपरेट रखेंगे, जो चीज हमें कॉमन चाहिए वो शेयर्ड रखेंगे. वी विल नॉट रिक्वायर्ड एक्स्ट्रा स्पेस, वी विल नॉट रिक्वायर एक्स्ट्रा रिसोर्सेस ऑल्सो. सो कॉपी ऑफ इंस्टेंसेस यस, बट कॉपी इज अ लाइट वेट कॉपी जस्ट बिकॉज लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स आर शेयर्ड. जैसे हमने ये किया, हमने कॉपी किया, रेप्लिकेट किया, पर सिर्फ बेडरूम को किया. क्यों? क्योंकि उसी की ही ज्यादा जरूरत थी सेपरेट होने की. किचन रेप्लिकेट नहीं किया. एंड दैट इज व्हाट द मेन इंटेंशन ऑफ गोइंग फॉर मल्टी थ्रेडिंग. सो अ थ्रेड इज नथिंग बट द कॉम्पोनेंट ऑफ प्रोसेस. इट्स अ लाइट वेट प्रोसेस. एंड वाई वी यूज इट? सो दैट मल्टीपल इंस्टेंसेस ऑफ थ्रेड्स वी कैन रन इंस्टेड ऑफ प्रोसेस, एंड वी कैन डू द सेम थिंग एज वी आर हैविंग मल्टीपल इंस्टेंसेस ऑफ प्रोसेस. तो प्रोसेस का मल्टीपल इंस्टेंसेस नहीं बनाते हुए वॉट वी डिड, वी मेड मल्टीपल थ्रेड्स विद इन अ प्रोसेस सो दैट ईच स्मॉल वर्क कैन बी डन बाय ईच पर्टिकुलर थ्रेड. Now, what are the things shared among threads? If one process is having, let's say, 4 threads, what are the parts of process shared between all those threads? So, the code section. Code section means the instructions. The instructions are shared between all the threads. Means if a process is having 4 threads, you don't have to copy all those process instructions in 4 different places. One set of instruction only will be shared by all the threads. Then data section. If any global variable we have, any static variable we have, all those global and static variables will be shared by the threads. Single copy of all, and all threads will access those. Then operating system resources, then open files and signals. All these will be shared among all the threads. Only single copy available for a process. You don't have to multiply these so that we can save a lot of space. Then what are the things which are not shared? Means each process has its own thread ID, the register sets. Means if a thread is using some registers, its collection in the PCB, you remember? And then stack. Each process will have a stack, yes, but each thread also will have its own stack. Why? Just because thread can have the local variables, function parameters, separate. Each thread will have its own unique stack, and program counter also will be unique. So what exactly we are doing? We are doing this particular thing. If we have a process, single thread, a process will have one code. Code means instructions, data, files, stack, registers and everything. Yes. If we copy entire process, it will take this much of copy. Code also copied, data also copied, files also copied, register also, stack also. Lot of things we are having duplicated, lot of resources required. But if we go for multi-threading option, look at this. In multi-threading, we are having single code, common, data, common, open files, common, register and stacks. We have made separate for each thread. So we are replicating only small register stack things only. Remaining all are shared, which can save a lot of space in the memory, which can save a lot of resources for me in the system. Right? So thread is just a part of a process. Among the process, you will create multiple threads so that threads can operate concurrently and can perform the operation, intended operation, on multiple instances, and yet we can have a code sharing, data sharing, file sharing, so that we can save the resources also. And that is what the thread. Now, what are the advantages of multi-threading? The advantages are, first of all, responsiveness. If you are having multi-threading, the responsiveness increases. Why? Just because threads are small part of process, and because of threads, which are lightweight process, responsiveness of the system increases. If suppose you are multiplying the processes, the system becomes little slow. If you are multiplying the threads or increasing the threads, it can still have the system faster just because lots of things are shared. Then we have faster context switches. Just because process is very large, context switches may require lot of time. In the threads, we may have faster context switches. Then resource sharing. Of course, I told you code, data, files are shared. So resource sharing is there in the multi-threading system. Then economy. Of course, money will require less. Why? Just because if you are going for multi-threading, you will require less size memory. If you are implementing a big web server, on that web server, you are implementing multi-threading rather than multi-processing. Right, that if rather than multiplying the processes, we are multiplying the threads, in that particular case, the economy will be really, really good. Economically, it will be really good to have multi-threading, just because sharing is too much means required resources are less. Then communication. Of course, the threads are of single process, then they can communicate with each other easily. Why? How? Just because they are having lots of things shared, code, data, files and all, and they are on the single process only. And then last one, utilization of multiprocessor architecture. If we have multiple processors, CPUs, multiple CPUs, then on multiple CPUs, we can run multiple threads concurrently, and all threads can run parallelly. Yes, now parallelly. Why? Just because you have multiple CPUs. On one CPU, one thread running, one CPU, another thread running, and this multi-threading can have a really, really good utilization of multiprocessor architecture. Sure. Let's go ahead. आगे बढ़ते हैं. आगे कहाँ बढ़ेंगे? एक कदम आगे चले जाओ. Okay. Now, what is this? Types of thread. Now, multi-threading you can do in two types of processes. Either you can apply multi-threading in user processes, or you can apply multi-threading in OS processes. OS means kernel processes, right? If you are applying the multi-threading concepts in user processes, then those threads are called as user level thread. If multi-threading is applied in kernel level thread or kernel level or kernel processes, then it is the threads are called as kernel level thread, right? Now what happens? What keeps track of all threads? Question is there. What keeps? Whoever is managing the process. If user process thread is there, then process will manage the threads. If kernel level thread is there, then operating system kernel will manage the threads. The threads will be managed by the process. Process. Sure. Aage badhte hain. Aage badhte hain. और डिफरेंस देखते हैं यूजर लेवल और कर्नल लेवल में. ये डिफरेंस बाद में समझ में आएगा, पहले ये समझने की कोशिश करते हैं. सी, आई एम द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम फॉर दिस क्लास. आई एम मैनेजिंग एवरीथिंग. यू आर जस्ट थ्रोइंग द क्वेश्चन. आई एम सॉल्विंग एंड एवरीथिंग आई एम डूइंग. इफ आई एम मल्टी थ्रेडिंग माई सेल्फ, दैट आई एम हायरिंग वन पर्सन हु कैन गिव द आंसर ऑफ योर डाउट्स, who can solve your questions, who can provide some extra doubt solving classes or problem solving classes or practice classes, means I know, I am aware that what kind of work me and my assistants are doing or my associates are doing. But let's say I have assigned a work to you. I have assigned a work to you. Fine. Now, if that particular work I have given to you, and I told you that this particular work you will have to do in next 3 days, I am not aware that how you will perform that operation or how you will complete that work. What you did, if you are doing by self alone, that is a single process. But let's say you made or you thought like that way, sir ne mujhe 5000 rupees diye, Sir has given me 5,000 rupees for this work. I don't have much time. Let me do one thing. I will hire two more members. I will pay them 1,000 each. And in 2,000, my work will be completed. So 2,000 you have paid to two other fellas. They have done the work for you. And you have reported me, sir, my work is done. You can give me 5,000 rupees. You saved money. Yes. But was I aware that how you completed the work? No. Why? Just because I have assigned you the responsibility. You are the user, I am the operating system. If operating system is multi-threaded, operating system is aware of it. If operating system is multi-threaded, if there are multi-threading implemented, if there is multi-threading implemented in the kernel, in the operating system is aware of it. But if user process is implementing the threading, multi-threading, operating system ko pata nahi chalega. So user process is like, kisi ko batana mata, kisi ko batana mata. हाँ, मैंने 5,000 सर से लिए 2,000 में काम करा दिया. डोंट से टू एनीबडी, डोंट स्पीक टू एनीबडी एंड डोंट लेट द ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम नो दैट आई एम मल्टी थ्रेडेड. सो यूजर लेवल थ्रेड्स के बारे में ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम को पता नहीं होता. नहीं पता. ऑपरेटिंग सिस्टम कैन सी अ प्रोसेस. नाउ दैट पर्टिकुलर प्रोसेस इज हैविंग अ सिंगल प्रोसेस, सिंगल थ्रेड और मल्टी थ्रेड. कर्नल इज नॉट अवेयर ऑफ दैट. जस्ट बिकॉज kernel is actually unaware of user level threads. But if you are having multi-threading in kernel level, then kernel knows about that, operating system knows about that. Chalo, ab difference dekh lete hain. What is the difference between user level threads and kernel level threads? Okay, if you understood, we are implementing the multi-threading in user processes. So I'm writing here, aapke multi-threading in user processes and here in operating system kernel processes. चल ये देखो, multi-threading in user process, multi-threading in kernel process. Created without kernel intervention. Kernel को कुछ भी idea नहीं, कोई idea, कोई भनक नहीं है कि हो क्या रहा है user process में. Kernel doesn't know what is going on in user process. Right? Like आप लोगों की जो secret party की या secret trip की जो planning होती है college में और घर वालों को नहीं पता होता है, exactly same thing. Kernel itself is multi-threaded. In the kernel thread. So kernel knows that there are multi-threading. Context switch is very fast. Why? Just because kernel is not involved. Operating system involved nahi hai, to process ek bar execution mein de diya. When a process is executing, its one thread is executing between switching between the user threads. Kernel is not involved. User process itself can have a switching. It is very fast. But here kernel level threads are having little bit slow context switch. Why? Just because kernel is involved, operating system is involved. When operating system is involved, it will take extra time. Jaise ki aap, when I have given you some work, coordination between you and your two associates is easy. You are not letting me know anything, right? But if you are telling me, I am aware that I am doing the multi-threading. Of course, if you are involving me, the process will become tedious. It becomes little slow. One thread is blocked, OS blocks entire process. Agar ek ka kaam bhi pura nahi hua, to main paise nahi de raha. If a simple small work is also not completed, I am not gonna give you money, right? If among those two associates, if one failed to do the job, I am not going to pay you. Exactly. If any of the user process thread is going for IO operation, kernel can see only one process running. Kernel cannot see the thread. Kernel sees only what entire process ki ek process hai. Mujhe nahi pata hai ki kitne thread hai usme. No, kernel will not be able to see that. Suppose one of the user process thread has gone for IO operation. Means it is blocked? Yes. So what operating system will do? Operating system will block the process. Why? Just because operating system to knows only one thing, that there is only single process. Operating system is not aware of multiple threads. Kernel is operating system. Right? So yahan pe agar ek thread bhi block hua, to puri process block ho jayegi. Why? Just because operating system can see only one process in the background, multiple threads are working in user process. Here, individual thread can be blocked. Why? Just because the OS, the kernel is actually aware of this particular point that the multi-threads are there. If one thread is blocked, that thread is only blocked, remaining threads can still run. So user level threads are generic and can run on any OS. Why? Just because operating system is not aware of such kind of threads. These kernel level threads are specific to operating system. Means when you actually implement the operating system, when you develop the operating system, at that time only this particular thing will be implemented. User threads are faster to create and manage. Kernel threads are slower to create and manage. Again, the same thing, that user threads are faster to create and manage just because user level process is not involving operating system, not involving kernel in this procedure. But kernel is involved, it becomes slower. चल आगे बढ़ते हैं, बात करते हैं मल्टी थ्रेडिंग मॉडल. मल्टी थ्रेडिंग मॉडल मींस वी मे हैव वन और मोर थ्रेड्स इन यूजर लेवल, वी मे हैव वन और मोर थ्रेड्स इन कर्नल लेवल. सो हाउ दीज थ्रेड्स विल बी हैविंग कम्युनिकेशन, विल बी हैविंग इम्प्लीमेंटेशन, that a user level thread will be connected or will be implemented in the kernel level with how many threads. Ek thread user level ka kitne kernel level ke thread ke saath mein communication karega. First one is many to one. Ab ye many to one kya hota hai? Many user level threads are implemented and performed by single kernel level thread. If that is the association between the threads from user level to kernel level, it is called as many to one multi-thread. Then we have one to one. If one user level thread interacting with one kernel level thread and performing its operation, then it is one to one. And we have one more, many to many. It says what? When we have many different user level threads communicating and having the association with multiple kernel level threads, then that particular model is known as many to many multi-threading model. So these are three different types of multi-threading models, that how a user process is associated or user level thread is associated with kernel level thread. Understood? So remember, threads and multiple threads or multi-threading is nothing but we have implemented this multi-threading because we wanted to have the same copy of process, same operation of a process for different instances, but we did not want, we will not want that we will replicate entire process. Few things we can share, yes, in the multi-threading we can share lots of things, and we will have the duplicate or we will have the replication of only few content which is required for thread execution. So multi-threading of course increases the performance of the system, increases the economy or economical benefits, plus increases the parallelism and increases the speed of the system also. how the context which happens in the threads, Nimishka, if the thread is kernel level thread, then the context which happens like a general process. But if you talk about user level threads, then operating system is not involved. User level thread automatically will understand that this thread will run, after that this thread will run, and this thread will run. So user process will switch only few data like registers and PC and all, that's it. Remaining data will remain as it is, and kernel process will execute, and user level threads will switch in between. Got it? Fine. So today's lecture is over. Only informative part we had for the threading and multi-threading. Tomorrow we are going to discuss system call and fork. And we have Friday, a very, very important day, just because Friday we are starting the most important topic, and that is memory management. This is very, very important, and you will have really, really great learning in this memory management topic. But before that, I told you Friday we are having a special session at 4:15 p.m. Remember that? What is the 4:15 p.m. session? That particular session we are going to solve CPU scheduling ke complex problems. And this is gonna be very, very useful for all those members who want to solve the tough questions on the CPU scheduling. Then you have a very, very special Saturday also. Why? Just because on Saturday we are going to have data structure revision. Remember that, 9 a.m. So these are very, very important part of learning you guys are having. Every Saturday 9 a.m. we will be having marathons. This is also gonna be a very, very long session, not a small session, at least 1.5 hour, so that you will be having lots of problems to practice, and some tough questions I'm gonna bring so that you can understand how to solve those tough questions. Anybody who would like to join an Academy Plus, join it today. Why? Just because we have an offer today. That offer is, if you take subscription for 12 months, 2 months extra subscription you will be getting. And then if you take subscription of 24 months, 3 months extra you will be getting. Why these extra? Just because you can cover up other PSU exam like ISRO, BARC and something, if it will be happening, or you can cover up your interview preparation also, if in the GATE exam, at the end of GATE exam, you are going to give the interview for master's admission. Sometimes you will have to give the interview. Why? Just because if your rank is not good and you are aiming for a good interview or a good IIT, you may have to give some kind of interview. Use this code VDEEP10 for your subscription so that you can get 10% discount, plus you can get this unlocked. It's up to tonight only, up to 2nd June, tonight only. So remember, I'm telling you, this is only the offer till tonight. So take the subscription as soon as possible, today only. The benefits are so much, but depends if you want to take those benefits into your favor or not. If you want the PDF of the classes available here on this Telegram channel, if you want to practice, lots of questions available, 10,000 questions across the branches, across the subjects on the Unacademy special classes, join those classes. Use this code to unlock the free classes. If you want to get more discount on Unacademy Plus subscription, you can write every weekend. You can write every weekend the scholarship test, which is Unacademy Combat. Next weekend, 6th of June, 11 a.m., you're gonna have the Unacademy Combat. It will be 60 minute, 20 question combat. If you will give more accurate answers as quick as possible, you will be in the toppers. To unlock this Unacademy Combat, you just use this code VDEEP10 and write this test. This particular test can give you two things. One, you can understand where your preparation is lying. Second thing, you can get, if you can get into the toppers, you can get into the Unacademy Plus with more discount. How much? If you get rank 1 to 3, you will be getting 100% discount. If your rank is 4 to 10, you will be getting 75% discount. If you will be getting rank 11 to 50, 50% discount. Rank is 51 to 100, 25% discount. Combat every Sunday, 11 a.m. If you are enjoying the lectures here, then please support the channel. How you can support the channel? By liking the sessions every time you come here, sharing these sessions, sharing the channel's content over your social media and over your all the connection groups. Subscribe the channel if you have not and turn on the notification so that you can get the notification whenever I come live for the classes. And then thank you so much for joining. Keep learning happily and I will try that aap logo ka learning aise hi happy chalta rahe. See you soon tomorrow. Till then, have a great day ahead.